Samsung QE55Q8C QLED review. The QE55Q8C QN55Q8C in the US is the third TV we've tested from Samsung's new QLED range. It sits between the Q7F and the top-end Q9F, both seriously impressive TVs in many ways. As such, it's no surprise to find the Q8C serving up exceptional brightness and a huge color range, while also using class-leading screen filters to deliver unprecedentedly excellent pictures in bright room conditions. However, it's also no surprise to find its HDR-friendly charms coming at the cost of a few backlight issues. While I personally have a soft spot for the clean, industrial design of Samsung's flagship TV for 2017, the Q9F, I suspect most people will prefer the look of the 55-inch Q8C. Its W1226XH706XD91mm black and silver frame is less in your face, its edges look thinner, and its centrally mounted metallic bar-style stand helps to create a lighter, more airy feel. The silver metallic rear panel also feels less severe than the darker, monolithic back of the Q9F. Although this only matters if you regularly look at your TV's back end. The one controversial thing about the QE55Q8C's screen is that it's curved, in stark contrast to the flat Q7F and Q9F models. For an in-depth look at the reasons behind curved TVs, check out our handy guide Curved TVs, the pros and cons. The QE55Q8C is as well made as it is attractive, feeling sturdy on its stand and catching your eye with the sort of opulent metallic gleam you'd hope to see from a TV costing £3,000. Supplied with the set are two remote controls, a normal one packed with all the traditional buttons, and a more minimalist smart remote. The latter is actually something of a revelation, combining a metallic form with a sensibly reduced button count, an ergonomic layout, and access to the most straightforward and usable voice control system yet seen on a TV. As you'd hope of a TV that costs £3,000, the Q8C supports both a native 4K resolution and HDR playback. In fact, its HDR support extends beyond the HDR10 industry standard format to the new hybrid log gamma, HLG, format set to be used for HDR broadcasts. It also supports the new HDR10+ format, an open-source rival to Dolby's metadata-toting Dolby Vision. Amazon Video has announced that it will support HDR10+, but no other sources have yet been confirmed. Samsung doesn't support Dolby Vision despite it being available on Netflix, Amazon, and Ultra HD Blu-ray disc. Arguably, the Q8C's most important feature is Samsung's QLED technology. This seeks to improve on the already established quantum dot approach to color reproduction by wrapping the QDs within a metallic casing so that they can be driven harder. This should result in better brightness and color performance. The QE55Q8C's connections are all carried on an external One Connect box, and comprise 4 HDMIs, 3 USBs, Bluetooth support, and both Wi-Fi and Ethernet network options. The network options support multimedia streaming from networked DLNA devices, and access to Samsung's wide selection of connected TV services. The USB ports can be used to record to USB drives from the TV's FreeView HD tuner, or to play multimedia from USB storage devices. The One Connect box attaches to the screen via a single cable, to reduce cable spaghetti. This connection cable is so thin and so nearly transparent that, from a distance, the TV looks like a completely cable-free zone. You'll still have to hide the power cable, mind. Samsung's latest Eden Smart interface is the brand's most effective system yet. It uses a well-presented and slick two-tier icon system to streamline access to content sources. It makes it easy to customize which apps and sources appear where on the homepage. It's good to see that Eden now supports the BBC iPlayer, ITV Player, all 4 and MY5 catch-up TV apps, as well as the more predictable Netflix and Amazon Video services. Incidentally, these latter two services can be enjoyed in 4K and HDR on the Q8C when the show you are watching supports them. According to Samsung's official figures, the Q8C is capable of hitting light peaks of around 1,500 nits, one of the highest figures I've seen on a TV to date. My own measurements reveal a more realistic peak of around 1360 nits, but this is close enough to Samsung's claims to suggest that the set can indeed momentarily hit 1500 nits or so over small areas of the screen that contain areas of extreme HDR brightness. These sort of brightness figures should enable the Q8C to deliver HDR's brightness peaks more effectively than most current TVs, as well as giving colors a more real-world intensity or volume. Getting the QE55Q8C's screen mounted onto its stand is complicated and fiddly. Steps include laying the TV in its box face down on the floor, and ripping off one side of its box. It's easy to imagine it becoming damaged at the hands of people in a rush to get their new TV up and running.